Hey, and welcome back to Beals Science. I'm Craig Beals, and I am super, super stoked that I get to share one of the coolest metals on the periodic table with you today, and that's gallium. Now, gallium's crazy because gallium can be poured into my hand, and it'll melt. So then I've got liquid metal. Now, if we're gonna talk about gallium, we first gotta look at the periodic table. Here's gallium. It's number 31 on the periodic table, and it's in this sea of metals, which means it is a metal, even though it melts at a lower temperature than most metals. Now, there's a lot of amazing things about this metal. I made a mold so we could really look at the melting point here. Gallium melts at 85.57 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 29.76 degrees Celsius. Now, my skin is warm enough to melt that, which means you can hold liquid metal in your hand, and it's non-toxic, it's safe, and it's awesome. Look at this. Below 85 degrees Fahrenheit and 29 degrees Celsius, you get this. Solid. The quickest way to get gallium to melt is to get the temperature up real quick like. So I'm using water at about 195 degrees Fahrenheit, and I'm just gonna set the tube of gallium in there. Notice, it starts to liquefy very quickly. And then you get this, liquid metal. Now, why am I using gloves? Well, it's non-toxic, but it leaves a residue on your hands, kind of like graphite from a pencil all over your hands. So if you're gonna be using a lot of gallium, just put some gloves on and you don't end up with quite the mess. And while it is non-toxic, it's really hard to say what playing with gallium for extended periods of time might do to you down the road. So that's why I put the gloves on. Now, here's my little syringe. This is gonna come in handy for all the creations I'm gonna make, or at least try to make, with gallium. Isn't this amazing? It's time for you to get some gallium. Like, for real. I totally get lost in playing with the metal. I decided, hey, you know what? I wonder if I could pour some of this in one of those glass bulb ornaments and then shake it around, and as it cools down, it should solidify, and I've got this wicked awesome Christmas ornament that's got a gallium coating on the inside, and it would be all mirror-like. So this was just truly me experimenting to see what would happen. And I must say, I was quite pleased with the result. Check it out.
That's what I'm talking about. That's where Christmas and chemistry collide. Right here, with a gallium mirror ball ornament. Isn't that lovely?
Ah. I mentioned earlier that I wear the gloves because you get a residue all over your hands. Well, I got to thinking, hey, if this stuff is kind of like graphite and it's a metal, what if I made a pencil filled with gallium? So I hollowed out a pencil, and then I melted some gallium, and then I injected the gallium into the pencil. Finally figured out a pressure system here. Watch. Got it. And then I put it in the freezer, shaved it down to a nice fine point, and then I had to see if it would actually work. And check this out. I made a pencil with gallium lead. And look at this metallic shine on the paper. Isn't that cool? With a little work, you could have a nice pencil collection of gallium pencils. I don't know why, but you could. Check this out. This is a gallium spoon. It's a spoon made of gallium. And of course, gallium is a metal, so it looks just like a normal spoon, but remember, it melts at a different temperature. So in the hot water, yeah, melting spoon. This is an old parlor trick from the 1800s when chemists would make a spoon out of gallium and give it to one of their guests to stir their tea, and it would melt. It was called the disappearing spoon. Isn't that amazing? Now, here's the mold I used, and I went through so much work with the mold and trying to make my own molds and trying to get this spoon thing that I've made a completely separate video about the gallium disappearing spoon. Now, there's a link in the description. Check it out and learn how to make your own gallium disappearing spoon.
You know, it's really important to remember that science and the elements are really quite fascinating, and gallium is a good reminder of that. You know, there's other videos popping up on the screen. If you like what we got going on over here, come on over to BealsScience.com. There's a lot more over there. But the real point is this: keep on learning.